says that we're live right now, Ryan.
How would we know, though?
Because it says in that little corner down there. Oh, I know. And, yeah. So, hi. We're a little bit of a technology work in progress because we've just never done
stuff.
This before.
Just messy stuff.
We've never done anything like this before. And Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
And we're gonna play some tunes.
Well, hello.
Can you hear us? Someone said hello.
That was Jenny Fernet.
Hi, Jenny.
If you can hear us, we would love you to write in the chat that
you
can hear us.
I know, we're very nervous that we did this wrong. We're like super nervous that we messed all of this up. But what's it say, Ryan?
Hello from the big house. Hey, Pop.
It's Pops. Hi, Pops. Yeah. Hope everybody had a good...
Pop says yes.
Morning,
so
Pop
they can
says
hear
they
us.
Can hear us. Okay, good.
That's good to know.
That's super good to know because we can still move the microphone closer and things like that.
Well, Kristen is talking. I'm going to tell my parents, if they're not already here, to log on.
And I'm going to still get our music ready because we're a little behind because we got lost track of time practicing and making a set list and fun things like that. That you do to do a concert on the internet. So yeah, we're still getting all of our ducks in a row. But that's okay. We can do Kentucky Wassail. Can't see what any of the chat people say.
Oh, you can't.
No.
Wayne Seymour says, hey,
Hi, Wayne.
The Elder Seymour. Hey, Wayne.
Elder Seymour. Wayne. What's your name? And then let's do Kentucky.
So I was mentioning before we actually got connected, the vast majority of the songs we're going to perform for you today I had never actually heard before, so they were brand new to me. So they were a lot of fun to learn.
Can we put this in there for kiddos?
Of course.
And we'll get our youth to do it?
Sure.
Or you can do it on bass. And then this. And then that.
Sure.
Okay. All right. Let's do a tune for them then.
We will do a tune for you. Which one is this?
This is...
a fiddle tune?
Yeah. I guess I need a fiddle to do that though, eh? So this is... This tune is called Old Christmas, and it is in the key of G.
Just always gotta make sure.
Is in the key of G, and Old Christmas is January 6th?
Your guess
somebody
is good
will put
mine.
It, somebody will put it in the chat and tell us that we're either correct or incorrect. Old Christmas is the Epiphany, and... It marks, like, the end of the 12 days of Christmas, and in the Appalachians, people would celebrate all of the 12 days of Christmas and, like, celebrate together over all of those days, and this one is from the Alan Lomax collection, right?
I think so.
Yeah. This one I start by myself. Remember? Yeah. Thank you.
says new tip in the bottom right corner.
A new tip? A new tip for what? Are they going to give us money? Are they going to give us some money? Share to your groups. I don't even barely know how to do what I'm doing right now. Can't do all
Did
that
Did you ever
stuff.
Do Instagram?
Nope, I can't figure out how to do it. I ran out of time, too, because I have to keep this thing going. Okay. Here's one of my Christmas presents from Ryan, my new guitar strap. It's very pretty. It's yellow. With Queen Anne's lace on it. What'd you get for Christmas, Ryan?
I got a pasta roller. It's delightful. I can't wait to make my own pasta.
What else did you get?
Oh, I didn't get this sweater.
This you didn't get that? Oh, that's a different sweater.
I got a sweater.
The blue sweater that I got you.
A couple sweaters, actually, and they are fantastically nice. But this is not one of them. So, yeah.
I wonder what everyone else got for Christmas. Something good, I hope. Sorry, I'm looking up information about the song that we're going to do next, because I wrote most of it out.
There are 16 people watching.
Woo! 16 people! We better play them a song real soon or they're going to leave us. So, this song is called What You Gonna Name That Pretty Baby. And it's, I found it on, it's a funny story when you like, so I teach traditional music to children and lots of different people. And one of my students said, I want to learn this tune called Snowbird on the Ash Bank. And I said, okay. And I sent her, the Oscar Wright version of that tune, which is the version that a lot of people play. And she said, that's not anything like what I heard that tune sounding like. And she pointed me in the direction of a fiddler called Ross Brown, who's kind of a really interesting fiddle player, if you ever have the time to look up Ross Brown. But on this same album that she heard, Snowbird on the Ash Bank, there was this song called What You Gonna Name That Pretty Baby from a singer named Letha Eller. And she is from North Georgia, and she's the mother of, like, two other traditional musicians, like, old-time musicians from that part of Georgia. And she just sings this really pretty little Christmas song, and it's called What You Gonna Name That Pretty Baby. And she plays it on a very out-of-tune piano, which is really cool. And this is my new-to-me K guitar, 1950s, and my new strap that Ryan got me for Christmas. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. Shout it loud. back.
Merry Christmas.
Kind of a cute little song, right? Right? Thank heavens for Charlie for telling me to go listen to Ross Brown. All right, I'm going to put this down. Pick this up. I'm going to move this over. And get that all good. Hope everyone can hear us. We're still going, right? Yeah.
I think so. It says there are 25 people watching.
Yeah.
25 people watching
us.
That's
a lot of people. So we should tell them about the next song.
It's ready up.
No, I know, but I have to find all my historical information.
She took notes.
Well, I mean, I think it's nice for people to like know a little bit about the songs.
True.
So, this song is a wassailing song, and it's called Kentucky Wassail. And most wassailing songs are not of the Americas, so it was kind of interesting to find an American wassailing song. And this one was collected by John Jacob Niles, who also played this instrument, the dulcimer. So it's related to some other wassailing songs that I'm sure you all know and love. The Somerset Wassail, Gloucestershire Wassail, anyone? Wassailing was like a thing that people would do to encourage apple trees to bear fruit for cider in pre-Christian times. But it's like you go and you visit people and you sing on their doorstep, and if you're a good wassailer, then they're supposed to like give you treats. Like they're actually the people who you wassail and sing for and like do these luck visits for are supposed to give you things. So that's why you're going to hear in the song, like, it's also, if you know, we wish you a Merry Christmas, that's why people are, like, demanding figgy pudding, is because we wish you a Merry Christmas is a wassailing song, and so they say we won't go until we get some because they're wassailers, and it's, like, bad, it's bad juju to not give wassailers treats. So yeah, this is an American wassail called the Kentucky Wassail. You ready?
Yep. I read all my notes.
Okay, and I'm gonna try and play the dulcimer and not mess it up. Wayne, don't judge me. Don't be too judgy, Wayne. I learned everything I know from Wayne. If I was great, I learned everything I know from Wayne. And if I am not good, I learned everything I know from Wayne. Let's see. Wassail, wassail all over the town. Our cup is white and our ale is brown. The cup is made from an old oak tree, and the ale is made in Kentucky. So it's joy be to you and a jolly wassail. Good man, good wife, are you with? There was an old maid, and she lived in a house, and she had for a pet a tiny wee mouse. So the house had a stove, and the house was warm, and a little bit of liquor won't do you no harm. So it's joy be to you. us.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
Merry Christmas.
I hope Wayne is not claiming any responsibility for that shoddy
Maybe he's like,
not yet.
Maybe he's like, you did okay. You did okay for your second time playing the dulcimer in front of people. Slash in your living room where maybe no one can see or cares. But that's okay. Doing new things is fun. Okay. So we're going way back.
No, even farther.
Even further back than that. Back it up. Back it up. What do they say? Do we need to change the sound?
No, they say they hear us.
Good.
Which is good.
That is good because...
we have listeners then.
Yes. I mean, it's good until it's not. Let's put it that way. It's good until it's not. So we're going to take you, like, way back into the olden times with these next two tunes. We're about to go medieval on you all. Because nothing says Christmas like a little bit of, you know, Gregorian chant.
For Personent, that one.
This one's?
You didn't write, where's the...
There's one that I wrote on?
Not so.
Yeah, it's up here. Yeah, I wrote on all these. See how organized we are for you? See how...
We do this for you. Well, we're up to 27 now.
What? Then we better get on it and play some tunes.
Yeah.
Okay,
that one
so...
person is now annoying. Sorry. We're getting...
So this is Personent Hodie. Obviously, one of your favorite Christmas songs, I can tell already.
Joanne says, hey, yous.
Hey, yous. Hey, yous, guys. So, Personent Hodie is,
Chris Hansen says hello.
Hey,
hello,
Hansen.
Chris.
Merry Christmas.
Hello.
Oh, no. What's that? Missed video chat. We can't video chat with you now. We're doing something else, Bethy. Bethy, we're trying to play music for you. So Personent Hodie is chant. It's a Christmas carol. It was published in 1582 in a volume of 74 medieval songs with Latin texts by a Swedish Lutheran cleric. Yes, the best kind of clerics are Swedish Lutherans. It has strong links to medieval Prague.
Music stand is on fire.
It does look like our music stand is on fire. And we're going to go from Personent Hodie into a French medieval Renaissance carol called Patapan, but we are going to like have a little bit of fun with Patapan because
why
on earth would you not want to have fun?
In this day and age, we have
Patapan.
To have fun. We have to have fun wherever we can.
Yep.
So... many of you might know Patapan. This is a Blanton Mack switcheroo.
Oh gosh. We'll see how it goes. I think it's going to be great. I think that anybody who's watching us loves us enough to let us.
One more time, where's the one you wrote on?
I can't find it now.
Sure.
There's a lot of papers here, so.
There are.
You want to, you know. Can you remember from your brains?
Yeah. I hope so. Here we go.
Yeah, how'd that happen? Okay. That's the one where we're going to go up the really high one.
Give
okay.
You. See, that's what I needed written down.
Here we go.
Personent Hodie, chest full, are you lay loud and test? You couldn't.
Praising Christ, heaven's King, born on earth to save us. get it. Unless you want to play bass.
I'll play bass.
Okay. You get my ukulele.
Well, what key is it in?
In C. Because that's what I played it on ukulele.
Yeah, I'll play the ukulele then.
Woohoo! Double ukuleles coming at your faces.
Yeah. You want banjo uke?
No, I want my uke.
Do you want me to play banjo uke?
Yes, I want double ukuleles for everyone. So, yesterday we had a little Zoom call, and I learned that my nieces and nephew love a song called Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, and so we decided that we are going to do Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. And maybe Jack and Clarky and Joe want to sing. At their houses, Jack does a particularly metal version of Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. He knows Dasher and Dancer. He knows all about those guys.
Dave, we're sorry you're sick.
Oh no, Dave's sick?
Dave was sick, so this is the light at the end of his tunnel.
Wait, Dave Doyle?
Yeah.
Dave, I got my hair cut. I saw Iva. Coming at your faces here, folks. Let's see.
I haven't played this one in years.
We're just gonna... Okay, yeah, we're just gonna make up some chords there. Okay, Merry Christmas, Jack and Joe and Clarky, and I hope that you sing at home at your houses real loud. Okay, Jack? Dasher and Dancer. Go all metal on it, in a metal mood. Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. Ready? You know Dasher and Dancer and Prancer and Vixen, Comet and Cupid and Donner and Blitzen. But do you recall the most famous
rehearse that once.
We didn't. We just rehearsed it with Jack and Joe and Clarkey. Over Zoom. So.
Amanda Tant, hello, Amanda
Tant. Hi,
Amanda
Tant. Tant.
Chris Hansen is a bottle of Maker's Mark. Yes.
Yeah, we're not having any drinks, but we should have drinks after we do this next one because I don't want to blow out my voice. And that's going to be really important to my success in this next one.
We're up to 30 people!
What? Woo-hoo! Oh my gosh, we're internet famous!
Alright.
We're going to take a 20 second break.
Just because I got to get my banjo.
Just because she has to get a banjo. Famous last words.
And tell you all about a medieval
love song that became a Christmas song that became a Jeff Buckley song. Because nothing says Christmas like possible connections to Grail lore and Jeff Buckley.
This is being recorded.
Yeah, it'll save. Like, a live video is just save when you're done.
Can you upload it to, like, Facebook or YouTube afterwards?
Yeah.
Okay.
Why, Kevin wants to watch it?
Yep.
Sorry, Kevin. I couldn't figure out how to do Instagram Live. Okay, so while Ryan does this, I'm going to tell you about the Corpus Christi Carol. The Corpus Christi Carol is only associated with Christmas, like, very loosely, because it's, the words to the original Corpus Christi Carol survive only in its Christmas, derivative, which is called Down in Yon Forest. And there's American versions of Down in Yon Forest that have survived and were also collected by John Jacob Niles, although it's kind of suspicious as to whether or not John Jacob Niles, like, actually collected Down in his version of Down in Yon Forest, or if he, like, wrote it, because John Jacob Niles was known to get into some shenanigans like that. But it's kind of an interesting story, so... It's called the Corpus Christi Carol, but it's also called the Falcon Carol. And it's a middle or early modern English hymn. And it was found in a manuscript form by a grocer named Richard Hill in 1504. Sorry for the history lesson, but it's very interesting to me. So nobody knows who wrote the lyrics. Probably the most well-known melody associated with the carol is by Benjamin Britten. And Benjamin Britten's melody was, setting of the lyrics was recorded by Jeff Buckley, which is like the first place that I ever heard it, was on the Grace album. And I love Jeff Buckley and I love that his version of it is like soul-crushingly beautiful. But this version, this melody that's attached to the Hern Carol that we're going to do for you is from John Flegel's version of the Hern. And John Flegel was a really well-known, early music person. He played lute and he sang and he played Celtic harp. And he, apparently this melody that he's attached to the lyrics of the Corpus Christi Carol is a Breton melody, and it basically translates to the Falcon. And I'm not going to try and butcher speaking in Breton, but yeah, I just wanted to give a little bit of, background on that because it doesn't sound like a Christmas carol, but I love it, and, if you love Jeff Buckley, then maybe you will also love it. And if you love creepy, weird early music, then maybe you will also love it. I need my little scraper for my... Someone's tired of the history lesson.
No, he said nice... your mom says nice sixth chord at the end of the last one.
And that's all I know how to play. I just do
that's,
math.
That's jazz.
That's jazz, baby. I need a scraper for my fingernail.
I don't know where you put it.
I don't know where I put it either. Oh, here it is. Okay.
Yeah.
By that bed, there stands a maid, a little. Christmas. Very middle Christmas.
Medieval music is totally metal, by the way.
Medieval music is totally metal.
By the way.
It comes from the Iron Age.
Oh, booyah. Look at that pun right there. Oh, you know what we should do now? Breaking up Christmas, just to lighten the mood, you know?
Sure.
After all the medieval revelry. You know, I'd say give the people what they want, but I don't really know what anybody wants at this point. Because we're going to go from...
We all want so many different things.
Medieval song to... Breaking Up Christmas to... A really goofy kid song. So
Breaking Up Christmas is one of the first fiddle tunes that I ever learned, and on the bass. The idea behind it is that instead of celebrating Christmas on just one day, you break it up over the course of
12 days of Christmas,
so that you don't so the spirit of Christmas lives on. And
hooray, Jim! Hooray, John! Breaking up Christmas all night long.
Yes. So there's a guy named Jim and named John.
Water after all that medieval screaming, you know.
All them melismas and...
There were no melismas in that.
I know, I don't care.
This ain't Handel's Messiah. How many syllables are in the word rejoice?
All of them.
Rejoice! Like
yep.
That?
Okay, Breaking Up Christmas.
How many syllables are in Gloria?
Hallelujah.
That's how many.
Too many. One, two, three, go.
Oh, now?
Thank you. Lindsay Fowler.
Lindsay Fowler.
Hope you're still there.
Merry Christmas.
Latitude for my attitude. Okay. Oh, I need to retune.
On your ukulele.
Oh, bless. Why can't I just leave things where they belong?
Is it the instrument of destruction?
What?
I don't know. Are you good?
Sometimes Ryan likes to try and put puns where they don't belong, and it's hard to know, like, if they're better because they're bad, or if they're worse because they're bad.
We are not drinking Wassail, Mary. Chris Hansen's playing along on his new bass. Do you have
nice.
An upright? Or do you have a guitar, Chris Hansen?
Well, I hope that everybody...
Katie Phelps, Merry Christmas.
Yay, Katie!
Merry Christmas, Katie.
Well, I hope that everybody does sing along with this one. 2020 has been a major suck fest. It's been bad. I think we can all agree. And one of our friends was commenting on how appropriate the original words to "Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas" are, given that 2020 is the worst. So, we listened to it, and I'm not really a guitar player, so, well, I kind of am, but...
She's come a long way since she's gotten this beautiful cave.
I've come a long way in the past 3 days that I've been really practicing the guitar. And
practice makes better.
Our friend Jeremy says that he doesn't like his music to have too much math in it. Well, there are a lot of sevens at the end of these chords, and I had to really figure out how to make them. So, you know, just internet be. I know this may be a foolish plea for people on the internet to ask to be.
Wayne says he may have to break out his K archtop. By the way,
that's what I have, Wayne.
By the way, it's Gloucestershire is pronounced.
Is it Gloucestershire?
Or is it Gloucestershire? Like Worcestershire.
I think it's Gloucestershire.
Yes, Gloucestershire.
But it might be Gloucestershire. I mean, I don't live there.
Patricia Spina says,
hi, Patty.
Beautiful. And Becky, I think, are clapping.
Yay!
Is Patty the woman I met at Mary's wedding?
Yes, Patty is the organizer,
yeah.
Planner, oh, lady
hi,
with
Patty.
The vision.
Yeah, I remember.
Le grand
how could I forget?
Of making things happen.
Yes.
Yes. So I'm going to take one more sip of water so that I can sing some of these notes. And we really hope that you will sing Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas with us. And again, there's a lot of math in these chords, so I hope I don't mess up too bad. I don't know.
Is she okay?
Yeah. Next year, all our troubles
That's a good one.
See you, 2020. Get out of here. Pack it up. Pack all your troubles up. Get the heck out of here, 2020.
Gloucestershire.
Wayne, still on that. Okay. I want to be corrected if I'm wrong.
Sure.
All right. My favorite Christmas song is next, but I need to get a fiddle and put this down.
Thanks, Anne-Marie. Merry Christmas to you. Eric Blatt says that made him happy.
Good, Eric Blatt.
Or Hap-boy.
Hap-boy?
Yes, Hap-boy. Happy boy. Hap-boy.
I like that.
Chris Hansen, I'm still waiting to know if you got an upright bass or a bass guitar. Dave Doyle, joy be to us.
At least it's not woe be unto us.
True.
That's good.
True. Woe unto us.
Low. Low unto us.
But isn't it funny in church, whenever it's supposed to say low, you say whoa.
You say yo.
Whoa, how a rose air blooming.
Yeah. Yo, unto you, a child is born.
Whoa, Christmas tree. Whoa, Christmas tree.
okay, this is my favorite Christmas song. And
oh god. Okay.
Okay, remember what we're doing with this?
Yep.
Okay, and I'm not gonna mess it up either. I know that there's been doubts about my ability to do these things. Oh wait, but I should put on my hat for this too.
You need your hat, babe?
It's gonna fall off.
I know, but that'll be funny.
No, I don't want glitter all over my face.
Oh, okay.
Sorry.
Alright, I have a matching hat to go with my shirt. I shouldn't put it on for... It's good, right?
It's great.
Okay, ready? Oh no, it's falling off already.
See?
My glasses are supposed to hold it in place. Alright, here, this is Must Be Santa, best Christmas song ever.
Is this in?
G.
Okay, good.
So that's the kickoff. And then that happens in between here and here.
One more time?
We do this, I'm going to play this, and then I'm going to sing this, and we're going to sing this, and then I'm going to play this here, and then we're going to sing this, and then we're going to sing this, I'm going to play this here, and then you know what to do.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, catch that?
Here we go. One more, like, kind of random thing that we
put together. Ryan Clark said, congrats on remembering your part in the personal hoodie. Got it. You're welcome. Yep. It's a tough one. It's a lot of, hey.
the Fonzie's favorite part.
Brenda Logan says, beautiful.
Hi, Brenda.
Hello. Dave Doyle's a swashbuckling.
Nice.
John Blanton, that was awesome. Loved it. Kate Cowett.
Hi, Kate.
Says hi.
Hello. All right. So, how many times are we going through this one?
Three.
Oof. Okay. Here we go. This is a bunch of carols all smushed together. And then ending with not a Christmas carol.
I've already forgotten what to do with
to usher us all into the new year, not Christmas carol. At the very end. So here we go. And thank you for watching. And have a safe and healthy holiday. Here we go. Thank you. Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Wayne Fugate.
Wayne!
Hello!
Wayne!
There's a ninth reindeer. All of the other reindeer. You're
yes.
welcome. That's old news.
That's good news. That's good news.
Merry Christmas,
Merry
Wayne.
Christmas.
Merry Christmas,
Merry Christmas,
Dave Doyle.
Everyone, thanks for watching us goof around and play some really goofy and also some somehow very self-serious Christmas music.
Drinks it is, Chrissy. Birthday,
yes.
buddy.
Birthday, buddy.
Jackie Seacoy loved those ukuleles.
Yay. So now it's time to have a drink.
Yes, it is.
Woohoo! So
several is what you were gonna say.
Yes, we love you all. Thanks so much
Chris
for
Hansen's
watching. Some
comments are getting to them about 15 minutes after. Great, we'll be reading them for the next 15 minutes.
Sorry. Well, yeah, we'll read them after.
You can text us. You can email us. We miss you all.
We miss you all a lot, and we hope you have a very healthy, safe holiday. And we'll see you. Maybe we'll do this again with some more, like, mashup weird things of, why not? Mashup weird things of, again, oddly self-serious Christmas music with really, really goofy sensibilities.
Thanks, Amanda.
Bye. Merry Christmas. I know I'd be more famous with a viola, Chrissy. Love you. Bye.